Let me show you two really interesting products from Rightsonic. It's going to save you a lot of time and money in your business. It's called Audiosonic and Botsonic. Audiosonic is going to generate from text to speech using AI and really great sounding voices. And Botsonic is going to let you add a bot to your website with all the information from your site or whatever you decide, and it's going to auto respond for you. It's really smart and I really like this product. So I'm going to show you both in this video. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. What's up, SaaS Masters? Like I said, we are going to check Audiosonic and Chatsonic. If you want to check it out, link will be provided in the description with an extra discount coupon code so you can check it out. So let's jump over to my dashboard. And like I said, Rightsonic has several products, but in this case, we're going to check out Audiosonic and Botsonic. Botsonic being my favorite one, but we're going to start off with Audiosonic. So what Audiosonic does is actually generate text-to-speech with really nice sounding voices. Now, I've ran some tests right here with different voices, and just let me show you how really good these voices actually sound. So this is a WordPress one that I'm talking about, a rephrasing on digital world, and let me click play.
Vast expanse of the digital universe, software doesn't just exist, it serves. As tools become services, we find a familiar emblem.
Now, that sounds really good. That doesn't sound like a bot, okay, or some AI human voice. This is another one.
Running multiple WordPress sites, struggling with updates, vulnerabilities, and plugin management? Dive into this video as I walk you through the easy plugin management.
Sounds good, right? Let me test another one.
Running multiple WordPress sites, struggling with updates, vulnerabilities, and plugin management?
So that's the same one I used over here, but with a different phrase. Now, let me paste in one of the phrases right here. And you can see I have the information of the audio minutes that I have, and then I can change the voice. So in this case, I'll check out Daniel, which is the one you heard right now. How about Jesse?
Welcome to Audiosonic, your go-to platform for human-like text-to-speech experience.
All right, this is Bella.
Welcome to Audiosonic, your go-to platform for human-like text.
Jeremy?
Welcome to Audiosonic, your go-to platform for human-like text.
I like this guy. He sounds kind of punchy. So let's select this guy for this particular phrase, and I'm going to generate the audio, okay? So let's get this started, and it doesn't take a lot of time. So let's give it a few seconds. Okay, it's ready. So let's click play.
As stories unfold in bytes and pixels, a new narrative emerges. Beyond the code lies the essence of SaaS, and within the rhythm of the web beats the heart of WordPress. Dive with us into a digital symphony.
Okay, keeps going on. That sounds really good, right? So I can go ahead and download this right now, export the audio clip, or I can just go ahead and view the text, share link, or delete it. So it's really easy to use the Audiosonic product from Rightsonic. So I recommend if you want a text-to-speech that sounds really good, like a human voice, this is a good option, okay? Now, let's go jump over to the next product, which is Botsonic. I think this is my favorite. Let me migrate this. Here we go. So there's a really new version right now. So I created this bot, which I named it Miguel, kind of gave it that Spanish kind of sound. And I'm going to open it up right now. So let's view the bot. And what I like about this, it's that it's super easy to use. So what I did is I added some links in my case where I added the most important links. So I added these links from my site and this one from Facebook just to kind of give it some meta pixel information. So I added a different link. Let me give you a really quick test right now. So this is the bot that I've created and you can test it out right here. So it has my logos, the information like that, okay? So I'm going to ask it a difficult question, okay? So how do I connect the custom domain with API? So imagine responding something to that would be a really common question that's kind of technical, and maybe you don't have that information. Click enter, and let's see what it responds. Here we go. So to connect custom domain with our API, you can follow these steps. So here we go. Provide endpoint to your branded domains via API, update domain settings if you get that. And it's going to let me know what the sources is where I got this from. So it's right here. And it's this website, which is mine. And I'm going to go to resources, developer API. And there's several questions right here that are kind of complex. So connecting this. So let's ask it how I can, let's see something right here. In the accounts, how can I get the account with API? Okay, let's check this out. How can I get the account with API? Hit enter. And here we go. And it responded. Here we go. To get the account information from API, go to this particular link. Obviously, when you are logged in. and this will return the data, your API key. All right, let's gasket another one. So links, get a list of links, shorten a link. Okay, how can I shorten a link with API? Hit enter. And here we go. We got the information. So this is information that was pulled by Botsonic because it read the whole page and it knows what to respond. Now, how can I accomplish this with my site? Okay. Now imagine you have a Shopify site, you have a SaaS, you have a WordPress site, whatever you like. Okay. And you want to respond to these difficult questions automatically without being there yourself. Okay. So you have several options. One is dropping in a file, so a PDF, a doc, or a docx file, which is under 100 megabytes, which is more than enough, okay? And it's gonna read the whole document. So if someone asks a question about that document, it's gonna be able to respond. So that's super easy, right? Next option is we have a spreadsheet. So via CSV, again, we can drop in all the information and have it Botsonic read that information and be ready to respond. Another one is links, which is super easy, and that's what I did. I added the developer link. Here we go. I added my main link. I added the QR code link. So if someone asks about a QR code, it can respond. A bio profiles, and it has that information. So if I ask something about that, it will read it. So the file type is link. The status is trained. The update on. Let me add a really quick link right here. So I'll go to the blog. Just, it's nothing to read there, but just want to show you. I'll click on the plus button, upload and train, and boom, it's waiting. It's going to be processing, and then it's going to be trained. It's super fast, okay? Depending on the amount of content on that page. So it's processing now. The other way is with a sitemap. So with a sitemap, basically it's gonna read all your website. So depending on the plan you're on, that could be a good idea or not. So if you have a lot of blogs that you don't want the bot to actually read about, then don't use sitemap. But if you want to have, for example, my website doesn't have a lot of pages and it's just focused on that, maybe sitemap is a good idea, okay? Another one is the frequently asked questions. You can upload a CSV, first download the template. Let me grab this really quickly just to show you what it's for. Grab the template and here we go. You add the question and then the answer. So I can click enter and kind of write the question what a client or a viewer could potentially ask and then write a response. That way the bot knows what to respond via this sheet. So just upload the frequently asked questions. That's for training the bot. So you can see it's super easy, okay? Let me go ahead and skip that. Now, the actual settings for the bot, for how it looks, what it says, and that kind of things are over here. Jump into the settings, and we got the appearance settings. So like I said, I named my bot Miguel, wanted to give it that Spanish vibe. The company name, description, I didn't add anything. The company logo, the bot avatar, obviously add something nice. In this case, I just added some logos, okay? The chat bubble icon, the accent colors, subheadings, and all that information here. You got your bot settings. So bot settings for the bot template, response length, you want it to be short, medium, or long. Do take into consideration your limits. If you have a lot of limits on the plan that you selected, well, select medium or long. Let me go ahead and select long. Let me save it. Let me go ahead and refresh it just in case it takes a bit. And let me go ahead and ask again about the API, see if it's longer, okay? How do I shorten a link with API? Okay, let's click enter. See if it's longer. Yeah, it's much longer and more specific. I like this response just by looking at it really quickly. See, look at that. Imagine getting that response for someone that doesn't know. So send the post request to the endpoint, include the required parameters, URLs. I mean, typing all that by myself would take longer. Maybe this would even have a better response than what I would respond personally. So this is a really good idea, okay? So depending, like I said, on the plan that you have, select the response length. Multilingual support enabled, add support emails, use this limits per user. So if you don't want the user to abuse the bot, you can do that there. User limit warning, enable disabled, the starter question, add a starter question if you like. User form, so remember in the beginning, it asks the name and email, but I can add more fields. If that's something that I need, then I can do so there. If I want to ask for the phone number or maybe just remove the name, I just want the email, whatever, okay? You have those questions there. Next, you have the apps. So if you want to integrate with some apps, you got Calendly, consent agreement, and capture user form. And they'll be adding more in the future, okay? You got share. So to embed this bot on your website, you got several options. You got the embed bot, the iframe, REST API if you want to use that via API, and the integrations, Telegram, WhatsApp, or Messenger. Then you have your inbox. So the chats that are going on, you can view here. Check this out. So these are previous bots tests that I've just ran. For example, this was a minute ago and I have the response right here. If I know that there's something fishy going on, I can just go ahead and block it. If I know it's important, I can export it and I can view the users right here. So in this case, it's just my users that I just tested. But once you keep getting the list right here, you can export this and send it over to your email marketing system, okay? And last but not least, you got the analytics for Botsonic. So right here, the messages and the chats. Since I'm just running tests, they don't count, okay? But if you would run this really, then you have everything right here. So that is Audiosonic and Botsonic from Rightsonic. Like I said, my favorite choice is Chatsonic. So if you're already using Rightsonic, I think it's a really good option to use this, Audiosonic and Chatsonic. But there you go. That is these new features from Rightsonic that you want to check out. Link will be provided in the description alongside with the coupon code that you want to use. So that's a wrap for Rightsonic.